Want to start a blog with an easy and no-code solution? With Notion, you can easily transform your pages into web pages, which makes it ideal for simple blogging, but it is missing some key features for a professional blogging experience, such as custom domains, meta tags, AdSense integration, and more. In this video, we wanted to introduce you to BlogPro, which can easily transform your Notion pages into a beautiful blog with all the features you would want in a blogging platform. If you find this useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first step to using BlogPro is to make an account and log in. So if we go to BlogPro's webpage, you can click on Get Started, and here you can just simply sign up using this form. So when you first make an account and log in, you'll be able to go to this overview tab and it's going to be empty. So let's go ahead and click Start Your First Blog. Here we're going to want to start the new blog by duplicating a template. So let's go ahead and click Duplicate Template. Then it's going to ask you where you'd like to add the BlogPro blog template. So let's go ahead and add it to our private area. So now we have the BlogPro blog template where you can actually edit the content inside of your blog through here. And if we hover to the sidebar, you'll notice that it's under our private tab here inside of BlogPro blog template. So now if we go back and then we click plus add new database, we can now add that blog template database to BlogPro. If we go to select pages here, then we're going to select BlogPro blog template, allow access. So now if we go back to start your first blog, then we'll now see BlogPro blog template here and we can click publish. And let's go ahead and change the subdomain. So now we have the BlogPro blog template inside of BlogPro successfully. So the next step we're going to do is to customize it. So if we go to our customization tab, the first thing you'll want to do in the customization section is to change the name and the description. Unfortunately, this can only be done inside of your Notion page, so we recommend you to do that there. Next, let's go ahead and add our logo. So if we click here, we can add our own image. The next thing we can add is a call to action button. So let's say that we want to link to our store. We can type something like check our store and the URL. Other things we can add are header links. So these are also going to be shown in the navigation. So we could do something like about us, and then we can link to our about us page. After that, we can add things like footer links. So these can be things like our privacy policy with a URL. Another thing we can add are things like company info. So let's say the Organized Notebook LLC, and we can add our URL. The favicon actually has to be edited through our Notion database icon. So we're going to do that through Notion. The next thing is the cover image for your blog. And again, this is going to be whatever database cover image you add to your Notion page. And here you can choose your fonts, which is really nice. So we have, for example, 4 different fonts here. And if you want, you can reach out to blogpro.so if you're interested in a very specific font. The next things you can add are social links. So we can link it here, just as an example. The next thing we can choose is whether we want table of contents to show up. And this is already really nice, so we're going to keep it there. The other thing is the hero section layout. So this is just what you want to see when you first open up the blog. We're going to just go ahead with the title and description. Then there's also the post overview layout. So you can either do the default with 2 columns or simple with single columns. After that, you can choose to hide cover images from post pages. And then finally, you can remove the BlogPro branding if you have a paid plan. So let's go ahead and save changes. So now that we've filled everything in on BlogPro, we can go back to our Notion page for the BlogPro template. So let's go back here. And first, let's go ahead and change the title so that it matches our brand. So Organized Notebook. And we can add some kind of description here. Next, let's try out the blog section by adding our own blog posts. The first thing we'll do is change the cover. And for this first one, let's go ahead and add a blog post that we've already written for our own website, which is about how to create tables in Notion. We'll remove this icon here, change the author to the Organized Notebook. And of course, we can also change the date. So let's say that it's something like this. You can add description tags and whether it's hidden or not. And then what we can do is just add the text inside here. So now we have one of them filled in. So if we click out, and let's go ahead and put these in as drafts so we don't see them. And now we should have one blog post ready. And then let's go ahead and also change this icon here. Go to custom. And now everything should be set up to at least see something on the blog page. So here is the end result after we edited the Notion database as well as the settings inside of BlogPro itself. So as you can see, there's the About Us and the Check Our Store button, as well as if we go down, you can see the privacy policy and this social media link here. So all of this is really simple and easy to use and just a very minimal setup for blogging that still has everything you need. And if we go ahead and open up the blog post, you can see everything like last updated date, how many minutes it is to read, as well as these social sharing options. And then if you go down, you can see that these table of contents look really nice here as well, and you can really read the text easily. So now that we're happy with how the blog looks, let's go ahead and go to our SEO configuration. So this is what's really cool about BlogPro, is that you can actually rename your paths for your blog posts in terms of the link structure. You can also add SEO indexing, and this is only for blogpro.so blogs, but if you have a custom domain, you can also get that indexed as well. Here you can add meta tags so that search engines can understand your site better. The next thing you can check out is the analytics. So here you can see who's visiting your blog, site page views, average visit time, and bounce rate. And then there's the advanced section where you can actually add Google AdSense integration, which is really great, as well as pop-ups so that you can announce important information, and custom CSS and change root layout of your blog. Finally, here you can add your domain. So the subdomain here is what's being shown in the BlogPro URL. Then if you had a custom domain, you would simply enter it here. And then finally here, it's going to actually do a subdirectory. So that means that it would use your custom domain and then slash blog to show this BlogPro blog. Setting up BlogPro is extremely easy. Be sure to try out BlogPro, who is the sponsor of today's video, by using the link in the description. It's free to try, so we'd highly recommend it to anyone looking to be able to focus on writing and less on the technical elements of running a blog. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.